Hello dear students, my name is Dr. Vaishali Ghai and the name of this channel is Tricks by Chemistry Ghai. So today in continuation with chapter 4, class 11th, Chemical Bonding and Molecular Structure, the last topic we have is hydrogen bonding. So today we'll talk about hydrogen bonding. When we talk about hydrogen bonding, we should know what are the special conditions and what is the basic introduction regarding the same. So suppose I talk about any molecule which contains hydrogen in it. That means one important thing is hydrogen atom must be there, which contains hydrogen atom. Second thing, if this molecule which contains this hydrogen atom is linked with more electronegative atom like N, O or F, fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen. So this molecule when linked with more electronegative atom like nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, it forms a bond. There is a force of attraction. That means this atom attracts the shared pair of electron. So that the end of the molecule becomes highly negative while the other end becomes positive. That means suppose any atom containing some molecule that has hydrogen in it is bonded with some more electronegative atom of another molecule, okay, then it acquires partial negative, it acquires partial positive, and there is some force of attraction that holds the molecules together. I'm talking about the molecule, I'm not talking about an atom. I'm saying that this is a molecule that it is bonded with covalent bond. This is another molecule that is bonded with covalent bond. The condition is the molecule which shows hydrogen bonding must have hydrogen in it, and it is linked with a more electronegative atom. It may be nitrogen, oxygen or fluorine. So basically the thing is these two atoms show some hydrogen bonding in them and it is represented by a dotted line. Let us consider some examples. So when we talk about the example, first thing is we should know the condition. If we go through the condition, we can easily find out the example. So first thing is molecule must contain hydrogen atom in it. That means one molecule must have hydrogen atom. And the second molecule must have any atom either of F, O or N. That means highly electronegative atom. Now the thing is nitrogen and chlorine are having the same electronegativity. But nitrogen shows hydrogen bonding, chlorine does not. Why this is so? So we are having the third condition, and third condition says that the size of electronegative atom should be small. When we compare the size of chlorine and nitrogen, chlorine is comparatively bigger and thus it does not get proper bonding with the small size hydrogen atom. So I can say that chlorine, which has the same electronegativity as that of nitrogen, it does not form hydrogen bond because of its large size. Let us move further and we'll talk about certain examples. So when we go through with the example, first example we'll take is water molecule. So if I draw the structure of water molecule, I'll be having this structure of one water molecule, and these solid lines between water molecule represents covalent bonding, sharing. This hydrogen atom, say, shows hydrogen bonding with oxygen of another water molecule. Similarly, this hydrogen may form hydrogen bonding with another water molecule. What about this oxygen? This oxygen may form hydrogen bonding with different hydrogen atom. This way, yahan pe bhi hydrogen atom, this way. So one water molecule bonded with another water molecule through hydrogen bonding. Bonded with another water molecule through hydrogen bonding, another water molecule. So if I ask you, if I concentrate on one water molecule, let us concentrate on this water molecule. If I ask you how many hydrogen bonds are present in this water molecule, can you count? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So there are total 4 hydrogen bonds are possible with one water molecule. So these water molecules which contain highly electronegative atom, when it is linked with the oxygen atom, this oxygen attracts the shared pair of electrons and thus there is some polarity develop, partial negative, partial positive. This causes some force of attraction and we call it as hydrogen bonding. So water found hydrogen, water shows hydrogen bonding in it. Let us move further with some more examples. We'll take example of HF. Initially I have given you HF. Suppose I'm having a molecule of HF. This hydrogen combines with or shows hydrogen bonding with another HF molecule. So hydrogen of this one molecule and fluorine of another molecule will show the hydrogen, may show hydrogen bonding with another fluorine and will be having this type of arrangement. Clear? Let us talk about another example is ammonia, which has this structure covalent bonded with three hydrogen atom with one lone pair also. Now this nitrogen will form hydrogen bonding with hydrogen of another nitrogen molecule. Let me draw the nitrogen molecule this way and this is hydrogen bonding. Similarly, hydrogen of this ammonia may form hydrogen bonding with another ammonia molecule. Similarly, with this hydrogen, so we'll be having the hydrogen bonding also. So since ammonia contains highly electronegative atom nitrogen, it gets linked with hydrogen of another molecule. This is more electronegative nitrogen and bonded with another hydrogen atom of another molecule via hydrogen bond. So this is how the hydrogen bonding can be explained. Now if I ask you which one is a stronger hydrogen bond. So strength can be considered in terms of the electronegativity. Like suppose as I said only three elements can show electronegativity. So let us consider the hydrogen bonding between HF, HO and HN. When we go through the bond dissociation enthalpy, it has very high bond dissociation enthalpy. And it has very low, comparatively low is in the this case. Okay, so it shows that ki iske bond ko todne ke liye hame jyada energy chahiye. What does it mean? It means that this bond is comparatively more stronger than HO bond, than HN bond in the case of hydrogen bonding. Clear? So this is about hydrogen bonding. Now we'll talk about the consequences of hydrogen bonding. Let us write about the consequences because you'll be having direct questions on hydrogen bonding that is based on the consequences. So suppose I talk about water has maximum density at 4 degrees Celsius. Or if I say ice floats on water. Ammonia has high boiling point than phosphine. Though belongs to the same group. Water exists as liquid whereas H2S as gas. Some molecules like HF molecule dissociate and it gives HF2 instead of F minus. F minus nahi deta. It gives HF2 minus. Dissociation takes place. Similarly, association takes place. Carboxylic acids form dimer due to hydrogen bonding. They form dimer due to hydrogen bonding. All these are having same reason, that is hydrogen bonding. One more, sugar being covalent. We say that like dissolves like. This is the best rule of solubility. So sugar which is non-polar, which is covalent molecule, should not be dissolved in a polar solvent like water, but sugar dissolves in water. Why this is so? Alcohol dissolves in water. Why this is so? Because of hydrogen bonding. So there is new bond formed between these molecules and they hold them together strongly and thus we observe these consequences. Water is maximum density because when we see the structure of water molecule, we observe that there are some vacant spaces or cage-like structure observed due to hydrogen bonding. So vacant spaces are there and thus ice floats on water due to hydrogen bonding. when we heat the temperature, that means we increase the temperature above 0 degree Celsius, 0 to 1, 1 to 3, 3 to 4, we observe that whatever be the cage-like structure of ice is there, some bonds starts, hydrogen bonds starts to break, and the hydrogen bonding get break in from ice and it changes into water, and at up to 4 degrees Celsius, those gaps, those cages of ice has been occupied by the water molecule, and till 4 degrees Celsius, all those gaps has been occupied by water, and thus water has maximum density at 4. Ammonia that holds the molecule together, number of ammonia molecules can come, one ammonia molecule is more closer to another ammonia molecule, and thus they come closer, so they have high boiling point. We need to provide extra temperature to break this hydrogen bond also, this hydrogen bond also. So some extra temperature is required. So we say that we observe that ammonia has high boiling point than phosphine, pH 3. Water is liquid, H2S is gas. The states can be decided in terms of the molecules, how closer they are, the spaces between the molecules. So since water molecules are close to each other, I can show you the water molecules, due to hydrogen bonding, they come closer to each other and thus they exist in liquid state. Whereas in the case of H2S, no such hydrogen bonding is possible and H2S molecules are apart from each other. HF undergo dissociation. When this HF undergo dissociation never exists as H plus and F minus, rather it forms HF2 minus and F minus. That is a strong association with fluorine and hydrogen forming hydrogen bond. Carboxylic acid form dimer. Suppose I am taking an example of CH3COOH, that is ethanoic acid. Let me take another molecule of this CH3COOH. So H of this molecule form hydrogen bonding with this oxygen. Same H of first molecule will form hydrogen bonding with another oxygen. So two molecules combined together and we call it as dimer. Dimer means two units. So carboxylic acid exists in dimeric form and thus again it has high boiling point. Sugar dissolves in water because sugar has OH bonds in it. Water, O of this sugar and H of water get bonded with each other and there is a strong hydrogen bonding, and because of that bonding sugar readily dissolves in water, and same is the case for alcohol. So this all about the hydrogen bonding, and this all about is the chapter number 4. Thank you. Thanks for watching and please subscribe this channel.